Hello, hello.
So, if you ever had hip pain, ever know someone that's had hip pain now or in the past, when is hip pain not really hip pain? Let me clarify. I can't tell you how many times people tell me, they come in, they say, "Doc, I have hip pain." And then I point to, I ask them to point where the problem is, and they're not pointing to their hip. So what does that mean? Let me explain. So I'm gonna use this model that I have over here to explain exactly what I'm talking about. So let me set up my camera, all right, on the tripod. So here's what I'm talking about. So someone asked me, so they say, "Doc, I have hip pain." I go, "Okay, point to the hip. So tell me where the pain is." And then they'll point over here. Okay, they'll point right here, right? This area here. So that is not the hip joint, right? Oftentimes we get our names or words confused. Now, if they would say, "I have hip pain," and they point over here, let me see, right? You can see me. So here, right, or here, that is the hip joint. So laterally, right here. Let me tilt it down a bit more. Okay, so there is the hip joint, Okay, over here is the hip joint on the side, right? On the back is not the hip joint. Well, so people tell me I have hip pain over here. What they're essentially pointing to is their sacroiliac joints. For short, that's SI joint. Okay, so I showed you what that looks like on me, right? Let me show you what it looks like on a spine model. And for those of you who are on, thanks for watching. Throw me some thumbs up, hit the like button, and share with your friends, anyone that you know that has hip pain. So here's a spine model, low back only. So lumbar spine, pelvis, the upper part of the thigh bone or femur. Here's the femur head, the ball and socket joint. So if someone was to say, "Doc, I have hip joint," and they're pointing here, over here, that's the hip joint. I can address that differently than if they say I have hip joint and they're pointing here, which is the pelvis. So that's the sacroiliac joint. So most commonly people tell me they have hip joint and it's in the sacroiliac joint over here and over here. And there are some specific adjustments that we do to help correct that. What's important though is to assess the problem correctly. So we assess it through palpation, feeling, checking for spinal function and motion. I check for leg length inequality, both functional leg length inequality and anatomical leg length inequality. And I check their alignment on their x-ray, their posture, muscle tightness in the muscles that attach to the pelvis and sacroiliac joint and the hips and the thighs, which are very important. And then the corrective adjustments would be to actually align the sacroiliac joint and to correct it with manual adjustments to improve the alignment. And in doing so, reduces the irritation and stress and inflammation in that joint area, which is highly sensitive. When it's inflamed, can trigger a significant amount of pain response. And not only that, when you balance the sacrum, you're also balancing the rest of the spine as well, which is super important. So I hope that clarifies the difference between hip joint and lower back sacroiliac joint pain. There is quite a difference. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And we do corrective chiropractic care in our office. And the distinction is that we help to correct the structural alignments and abnormalities of the spine, as well as the posture, to improve people's overall daily activities of daily living and function, and as well as their health. Hope you enjoyed that, and I'll talk to you again soon.